So children, today we are going to go for grammar activities, okay? So this is again for our first lesson, Alice Adventures in Wonderland. So for which we haven't finished the grammar yet, okay? The grammatical structure in this lesson predicts us that it has some subjects and its predicates. So what are the subjects and what are predicates are? So I'll read the sentences. Okay, you also can see I have written here the children are playing. So the subject is children and the predicate is rest of the sentence. Okay, so the children are is a subject. Okay, and rest of the sentence is called predicate. So this is what it's predicate, children. Okay, done with this. And what is the second one? Robin mounted his bicycle. So Robin is the subject here and mounted his bicycle is a predicate. Okay, I hope you all understood, children. So we will have a small activity on this. So that is match the following, match the subjects to the correct predicates. So first is a cobbler. Do you know who is cobbler? Cobbler mends our shoes. So what is the correct answer for cobbler? That is, it has given in the option list is G. It, the correct answer for cobbler is G. Okay, so G is cobbler mends our shoes. Okay, the second is the sun. What does the sun do? Sun has its own light. It never depends on the other light. That is the option J. We are matching it with J. And the third is the moon. The moon shines in the night, right? So moon always, you can see if you go outside, it shines in the night. So we will do the next one, the fourth one, okay? Next is Pakistan. Pakistan is a country. So how we celebrate the Independence Day? So it also celebrates the Independence Day on 14th of August. So that is for fourth number we are matching H. Celebrates Independence Day on 14th August. Now for fifth one, butter. What is butter? Butter is made up of milk. So we are matching fifth number with option B. Next is tree. What is tree? Trees are the big plants. Those are the big plants. So we are matching the sixth one with I. Okay. So next one is peacock. Peacock is the seventh one and we are matching the seventh one with the option D. That is our national bird. Peacock is our national bird. Then eighth one is birds. Birds have feathers because they fly. So that is the reason we are matching birds, eighth number with F, option F, having feathers. What is ninth? Ninth is ships and boats. Ships and boats we can see only in the water. So ships and boats sail on the water. That is the reason we are matching ninth one with option C. And what is 10th one is a square. Square has four equal sides. That is the reason 10th one we are matching with option as A. Okay, done with this, children. Chalo, we will see the next part of the grammar now. So children, next part of the grammar is add suitable subject to the following predicate. So we have already know, we have already seen what are predicates. So we will do this activity. This is a kind of filling the blanks. So dash is the shortest month of the year. So February, because February has only 29 days, or sometimes in leap year it will have 29 days. So that is the reason we are choosing February is the shortest month of the year. The second one is dash is the last month of the year. What is the last month of year? You might be knowing January, February. So which one comes last? December. So December is the last month of the year. Then dash is the capital of India. What is the capital of India? Delhi. Delhi is the capital of India. Dash is called as ship of desert. So this is not like kind of ship which sails on the water. This is talking, we are talking about desert. So in desert you will find only camels. Okay, so only camel is the ship of desert. So fifth one is Dash is the pink city of India. So what is the pink city? Jaipur is called as pink city of India. And the sixth one is Dash is the tallest animal. Giraffe. Giraffe has long neck and it is the tallest animal in the complete world. So we are taking giraffe as the tallest animal of the world. Okay, so we will move ahead for the next grammar. So listen to few habits read by your teacher that some children have and say whether they are right or wrong. So we are going for this activity, and conversation skill activity should be done between you and your friend or between you and your siblings. So we are not going for conversation activity, we are going for let's listen. Okay children, chalo let's do it that also. Chalo, we will go for the next exercise. Listen to few habits read by your teacher that some children have and say whatever they are right and wrong. So first one is Hina likes to watch less TV and play more. So this is a very good habit. If you watch less TV, your eyes will not affect. And playing more is a physical activity. That is the reason we are making it as right sentence. So that is a right sentence. Next one is Neha rubs her eyes frequently. Rubbing eyes frequently is wrong, because when you rub your eyes, you use your hands. So hands have germs. So without washing, if you rub, your germs will affect your eyes. That is the reason this is a wrong option. Sumit shouts at everybody. Shouting is very bad. Okay, we should not loud our voice. So should not talk in loud voice. So that is the reason this is a not good habit. Okay, soft speaking is good habit. So fourth one is Ramesh eats with dirty hands. Without washing your hands, if you eat, what happens? As I said, germs will attack. So therefore, without washing hands, if you eat something, definitely germs will attack. So that is the reason Ramesh eats with dirty hands is a wrong habit. Okay? The next one is Ahana prays to God every morning. This is very good option. Whenever you have taken a bath, first you have to pray to the God. Okay, so that is the reason this is a very good option and very correct option. If you follow these things, definitely you will be getting some blessings from the God. Okay, chalo, we have done with the first lesson children, and we'll see you for the second lesson. Thank you. Bye children, have a safe day. Good day. Bye bye.